Hi everyone, I want to talk today about domain modeling and how we can use it to make our applications more consistent. It's going to be a lot of code, so the link to the slide is there. If you miss something, you can check it out later. And the examples are going to be in TypeScript, because they benefit from the type system mainly. And so it means they apply to any other of the other compiled languages. So let's start. We have here our type. It's modeling an asynchronous data. So we are saying that it can be loading or it finished loading. There can be some data in it or an error. So this is how we instantiate it. The different stages after it resolves, we see a success or a failure. And if we want to use it to present this information to our users in a React component, it will look something like this, right? In each of the cases, we do some checks and we show the relevant information to the user. This seems to be good. Yeah, we can send it to production and go to sleep, right? Well, what happens if we had something like this? It's totally inconsistent. It says that it's loading, but also we have the data and the error as well, all together. It doesn't make sense, but it compiles. The type is right. So from the type level, it's fine, but from our domain, it's not. And the problem here is that we don't have a single source of truth. All of the cases relate to each other, and the four cases we saw at the beginning of not ask, or failure, or success are combination of this. So our first guess can be to solve this, to add a bunch of tests across the application, to make sure that we don't get in this inconsistent state. But we can use instead the type system, and in particular, discriminated unions. This is a feature from TypeScript. I'm not going to go over the definition, just show how it looks like. Well, as the name implies, we have a union type now, and each of the cases have a status. So this is the type for, I think, data now. And we are telling the compiler that it can use this status to understand that there, in some cases, be some other properties. But the good thing is that we don't have optional values now. If we want to construct an object of this type and it's a failure, we need to provide the error as well. Otherwise, it doesn't compile. So we're removing all these errors that we saw before. And to show it in the component, it will look something like this. So now we solve all these problems. And personally, I like to take it with discriminated unions and a step farther and make it more declarative, the usage. Instead of being checking all the statuses by myself, we can define a matcher type. And this has different methods for the different case. So in each case, our matcher is going to accept a function that goes from the properties of that case to some return value. And if we compare, or we see how our component looks like, we can basically reuse the same logic of matching each of the statuses to a utility, a match utility. It's the same code, basically, and we're using the matcher to handle each of the cases. And now our component looks something like this, where instead of explicitly saying, if this, then do that, we just say, for each type, you do this. And then the matcher will do it for us. So as we started talking about, and sorry, this is how the whole thing looks like. There is more code here, but at the same time, most of it is utility. We can reuse it not only in React, but in the other places of our application. So as we started talking about domain modeling, we see that it can enable us to write more consistent and safer applications. So if you are interested in this, here are some other things you can check. They are in the slide, so just follow the link. Thanks.